नमस्कार, वेरी गुड आफ्टरनून टू ऑल ऑफ यू. वंडरफुल टू सी यू बैक हियर. फॉर मी दिस इज द फर्स्ट टाइम डूइंग दिस फिजिकल वन, एटलीस्ट इन दिस वीकली फॉर्मेट. ऑफकोर्स वी हैव हैड फ्यू मीटिंग्स और फ्यू ब्रीफिंग्स दैट वी हैव डन फॉर स्पेशल ओकेशंस, बट अनफॉर्चुनेटली सिंस लास्ट नवंबर लास्ट मार्च वी हैव नॉट बीन एबल टू रियली डू दिस. सो आई एम वेरी हैप्पी दैट वी आर नाउ बैक इन दिस फॉर्मेट. अगेन अ वेरी वार्म वेलकम टू ऑल ऑफ यू. I don't really have any announcements yet to make, so perhaps we will go straight to the questions. I know most of you, many of you, but I will since we've been out for so long and we have forgotten the ground rules, we shall limit ourselves to one question per person, like unlike the virtual one. We'll try to get as many people as we can, but we have a time limit also. I also apologize, we were having some technical difficulties today with the electricity and other problems, but I'm glad to see we're up and running. The other comment I would like to just make before we start is, please introduce yourself and the organization just for the microphone. I probably might know all of you, so. Okay, so how do you want to start? Okay, who should we start with? Ladies always, okay, please.
I'm Kadambini Sharma from NDTV India. कादंबरी शर्मा फ्रॉम एनडीटीवी इंडिया. मेरा सवाल अफगानिस्तान को लेकर दोहा में हो रहे बैठक पर है, उस पे कुछ अगर डिटेल आपके पास.
अनुमान ये है कि अफगानिस्तान पे बड़े क्वेश्चंस होंगे, तो इंस्टेड ऑफ टेकिंग वन बाय वन, अफगानिस्तान रिलेटेड लेट्स स्टार्ट ऑफ विद. ओके, नो प्रॉब्लम, गो अहेड. अफगानिस्तान में बड़े सवाल हैं, हम एक एक करके ले लेते हैं. अगर सिमिलर सवाल पूछ चुके हैं तो जरूरत नहीं है, पर आई वुड हैप्पी टू. एक सवाल का हमने ग्राउंड रूल किया था ना. अच्छा,
जो हेलीकॉप्टर दिए थे अफगानिस्तान को, ऐसी खबरें आ रही हैं कि उस पर तालिबान का कब्जा हो गया है, उसके बारे में हमारी क्या जानकारी है. दूसरा सवाल यह है कि जो वहाँ पर माइनॉरिटीज हैं, खासतौर से हिंदू हैं, सिख हैं, उन पर लगातार हमले हो रहे हैं, तो क्या उनके बचाव के लिए कोई रेस्क्यू मिशन या इस तरह का रिक्रूटिंग के फॉर्मेट में हम क्या उनको भारत ला रहे हैं.
अच्छा, और किस किस आप कह रहे थे.
शंकर सिंह एनडीटीवी से. मेरा सवाल ये है कि जब तालिबान एक तरफ से ग्राउंड पे कब्जा किए जा रहा है और कई सारे देश में अपने डेलीगेशन भेज के, जैसे चाइना भेजा और कई सारे देशों में भेज के वहां से अपने लिए मान्यता हासिल करने की कोशिश कर रहा है, क्या हमारी तरफ से किसी स्तर पे कोई बातचीत शुरू हुई है या कोई संभावना है या ऐसी कोई मंशा है सरकार
किन से
तालिबान के साथ कॉन्टैक्ट स्थापित करने की.
I think we'll do 4 or 5, but I missed one or two other people. We'll have another round of it. Sorry, you had something? Anybody else? Abhi, pehle first round. Who feel first round? You want to put something different?
Sir, India had many projects in Afghanistan.
If you could introduce yourself.
Hello. Akhilesh Soman from South Africa. India had many projects in Afghanistan that was ongoing. So, what are we doing to safeguard those projects? Even though we have told our people to come back, so who will take care of those?
Abhi ke liye, or should I come back to you? Keen? Okay, please. Yahan pe samne. Okay, I think I will put a pause here and try to answer some of this question, and I'm sure Afghanistan will have more queries. Look, let me make a few general comments. Let me start with, I think, Kandaman, you had mentioned. We had here a high-level visitor a few days ago, Mutlaq bin Majed Al-Qahtani, special envoy of the Foreign Minister of Qatar for counterterrorism and mediation of conflict resolution. He was here earlier this week from August 5th to 8th. As part of his official engagements, he, of course, met External Affairs Minister as well as Foreign Secretary. Discussions were held on the situation in Afghanistan, a need for a peaceful and stable Afghanistan. He also discussed, of course, bilateral relations with Secretary CPV. He had also extended an invitation to India to participate in a meeting in Doha today, 12th, which actually we have participating. Our joint secretary looking after Pakistan, Afghanistan and Iran is currently there, Mr. JP Singh. That meeting will include several important stakeholders from Afghanistan, and we'll also discuss further the support of the international community. This meeting is underway today, and we will share with you updates once the meeting is over. So that's towards our understanding the talks that we've had. On the security situation, look, it is of concern. It is a rapidly evolving situation. I think a couple of you asked this question. Abhi Newsgate, we asked about whether we have a timeline. Look, I'm not going to get into any such speculation. I've seen media reports. This is a situation on the ground. We continue to hope that there will be an immediate and comprehensive ceasefire. We are supporting all peace initiatives in Afghanistan. Our primary concern is peace and stability in that country and offering a prosperous future, independent, sovereign, democratic. We talked about projects, I think Akhilesh, you mentioned. Look, I think it's wrong to term them as, Indian projects. I think these are projects that were done with Indian assistance, Indian support, but they are projects of the government and people of Afghanistan. And once we hand over them, we don't make any claim ki wo humare hain. These are projects that they have. Of course, these are very useful and important projects for the development of the people of Afghanistan. And we certainly hope that they will not get damaged and will continue to provide the benefit. On the discussions with Taliban, we had, there's a query, Umar Shankarji. Jaise maine pehle keh rakha tha, we are in touch with all stakeholders, various stakeholders. And isse zyada main abhi kuch kehna nahi chahunga. हेलीकॉप्टर एंड कुछ सिक्योरिटी सिचुएशन की डिटेल्स पूछी गई थी. देखिए, सिचुएशन ऑन द ग्राउंड जैसे मैंने कहा इज इवॉल्विंग, इट्स चेंज. यू ऑल अवेयर ऑफ द डेवलपमेंट दैट हैड टेकिंग प्लेस. वी आर सीइंग डिफरेंट रिपोर्ट्स. द ग्राउंड सिचुएशन इज डिफिकल्ट टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज द एक्चुअल एक्यूरेट रिपोर्ट. देर वॉज अ टॉक अबाउट अ हेलीकॉप्टर विच वी हैड गिवन. इट केम इन द न्यूज, आई अंडरस्टैंड. लुक, ऑल आई कैन से इज दैट this is not something for us to comment. That wasn't the Indian Air Force helicopter. So I would, all I can say is this is the internal matter for Afghanistan. I would not like to comment on that aspect. Minorities pe pucha gaya tha. If we're bringing back minorities, I have something here on that. Let me mention that we are closely monitoring developments in this regard. We are concerned about the deteriorating security situation. Our mission in Kabul issued an advisory for Indian nationals earlier this week, advising them to return to India via commercial flights. Last year, our mission in Kabul had facilitated the return of more than 383 members of the Hindu and Sikh community in Afghanistan to India. And our embassy, our mission in Kabul, continues to remain in touch with the Afghan Hindu and Sikh community members, and we will ensure the provision of all necessary assistance to them. I think that covers the first round of questions. And if I miss something, please ask me again. Let me take if there are more questions related to Afghanistan. Yes, Alok.
Shrinjar, you had asked first. Please just take it.
आवाज जा रही मुझे सुनाई दे रहा है। No, sorry, that's Shunja. Oh, sorry, was there somebody behind? I don't know. Let's take that.
Hi, Reza from Hindustan Times. I was just wondering what is the feeling that there are too many processes right now underway on Afghanistan, and maybe there is a need for the international community to kind of consolidate these processes and work more in a more coordinated manner. And what specifically can India do right now to kind of shore up the Afghanistan? Is there any specific things that we are looking at? Any kind of support or anything else?
We've got about four questions. Anybody this round, or I'll come back for another round if you want. Three of you know, then let's wait. I can see a lot many more hands. Let me try to take some of these questions. Perhaps they will answer your queries. Look, let me try to take up the issue of evacuation or something was asked. I think there's some confusion on that. We had issued an advisory for Indian nationals to leave India, to leave Afghanistan back for India through commercial means. There's no formal evacuation mechanism. Separately, Mazar-e-Sharif, our consulate there, we have withdrawn all India-based personnel earlier this week because of the security situation. This is a temporary measure, and our consulate there continues to be operational with local staff, locally recruited staff. So I'm not sure what further details were asked on that element. Siddhant mentioned about what kind of conversations. So now let me just reiterate what we've been saying earlier. We are committed to the long-term development of Afghanistan. We would like to see a peaceful, prosperous, and democratic Afghanistan, which is, as our minister was saying, both at peace within and peace outside. We want a ceasefire. We want to preserve the gains of the last two decades, minorities, particularly related to minorities and women. And we hope that all stakeholders can find a peace process that takes it forward. And our conversations with all our partners in this are geared towards that objective. And I think I'll leave it at that. On the issue of whether too many processes or otherwise, look, there are multiple efforts going on. I wouldn't like to speculate on whether too many or not. If the objective remains as it is, which is to ensure that there is peace so that we can look at long-term development of Afghanistan. Shinjoy asked about the issue of what is our assessment. I won't comment on what you prefaced your question with. But we have been saying that for peace in Afghanistan, we need to ensure that the external malign influences there do not happen. We clearly are aware of how it is happening. And we would certainly hope that all parties, including regional countries there, understand this and work towards a situation where Afghans can have a process that is owned by them, controlled by them, led by them, as we have been saying. We certainly don't think that currently that's the situation. I think I've covered, we had a query also on how we can support Afghanistan. Look, on the development aspect, we have been doing a lot. We have been part of the international community in extending assistance to Afghanistan. But I don't know what exactly specific the query was. There was some armed support query. Look, I think, let me just mention that we are, of course, guided by the strategic partnership agreement that was signed between the two sides in October 2011. I think we are guided by that and we'll work with that. But I don't have any specific comment on this, on any element of armed support. I think there are speculation. I won't get into speculative comments that are in the media. Thank you. Some questions. Yes, please.
मैं तरुण प्रकाश दुबे हूँ जी न्यूज से। मेरा सवाल ये है सर, जिस तरह की खबरें आ रही हैं कि पाकिस्तान की तरफ से कई आतंकी भी तालिबान के साथ लड़ने के लिए भेजे गए हैं, यहाँ तक कि पाकिस्तानी आर्मी के कुछ जवान भी साथ में तालिबान के साथ लड़ने के लिए भेजे गए हैं, इस तरह की तमाम खबरें हैं, तो भारत को इस तरह की गुप्ता जानकारी क्या इंटरनेशनल मंच पर अंतर्राष्ट्रीय मंच पर भारत इस तरह की जो पाकिस्तान की भूमिका है उसको उठाएगा, क्योंकि पूरे इस रीजन को खतरा है पाकिस्तान जिस तरह से सपोर्ट कर रहा है तालिबान को।
There are a couple of people on this side.
Sir, this is Nirendra from Financial Express. This is regarding the Heart of Asia initiative, which India has been a very poor part. So, have the members discussed the current situation and is it playing a role in the Taliban crisis?
There was one more here and somebody else. Just finish with that. And this is the last round on Afghanistan, then we can go ahead to some other topic. Oh, you have more questions. Okay, please.
You have said that India is going to take care of the minorities of Pakistan. But there are also female lawmakers, NGO workers, human rights workers, translators of Afghanistan who are also seeking for that. What is the government of India's position on that? Are you open to giving them refuge?
You mentioned females specifically.
Also
females. Sorry, somebody else here. Let me finish with this one. Okay, last, yeah, please, ma'am.
Geeta, I'm moving from India today. In an interview to India today, Taliban spokesperson Suhail Shaheen said that there are conditions for India to be part of the talks with the Taliban, and that is, in partiality, that India should stop providing military help to Afghanistan. Your reaction?
Okay, let me take that round of questions. Have I missed anybody? Sorry. Yeah. You all get one question, huh? So all of you are going to use it in Afghanistan. Okay, fair enough.
Last thing is that we've seen that China has also shown great interest in Afghanistan and we're playing the Pakistan card, they are also playing a role here. So are you also, in fact, in touch with China and literally spoke of engaging with China to just, bring some kind of stability in Afghanistan? Are we, as we're talking to all the big powers, is also China?
Okay, let me try to answer some of those queries. Look, I think we are covering similar ground again on some of these issues. Let me take comments vis-a-vis Pakistan. No, I don't want to get into specific comment on that. Let me reiterate what I said. Pakistan ya baki कोई भी जिहादी एलिमेंट इस तरह के आपने पूछा था आई थिंक इसके बारे में कि बाहर से ऐसे कोई स्टोरीज हैं कि वो लोग आ रहे हैं तैयार हैं देखिए काफी रिपोर्ट्स इस तरह के हैं नहीं
मेरा सवाल ये था कि वहां से आतंकी भी भेजे जा रहे हैं तालिबान के साथ अफगानिस्तान आर्मी से लड़ने के लिए जिस तरह का सपोर्ट
जी हमने भी ये रिपोर्ट देखी है पर मैं रिपोर्ट्स पे मैं रिस्पॉन्ड नहीं करना चाहूंगा हम यही चाहेंगे कि ऐसे अगर ऐसी चीज़ें हो रही हैं तो बिल्कुल बंद किया जाए। पाकिस्तान के रोल या बाहर के किसी भी कंट्री या जिस तरह से कोई नेगेटिव रोल उसमें अगर प्ले कर रहे हैं उस पर तो हम उसको तो चर्चा कर ही रहे हैं और बाकी लोगों से भी इसी इस विषय पे। आई कैन से कि वर्ल्ड में सबको मालूम है कि किस तरह का रोल हो रहा है और किस तरह के कंसर्न्स उनके हैं कि पाकिस्तान की तरफ से जिहादी एलिमेंट कह लीजिए, आतंकी एलिमेंट जो उधर अफगानिस्तान में क्या कर चुके हैं। इस पर पूरी दुनिया जानती है, हमें बताने की इतना ज़रूरत तो नहीं है। और जैसे आपने कहा हमारे कॉन्वर्सेशन में ये बात आती है। We had some questions about how many Indians in Kabul. Look, the advisory was about leaving Afghanistan. Registration is usually what we do. I don't have a number for you here. I'm not sure we would like to also discuss it publicly at this point. But all I can say is we would request Indian nationals who happen to be in Afghanistan even now to look at ways to come back at the early while commercial flights are still going on. We also, you asked about, again, assessment of how fast Kabul will fall. I thought I answered that question earlier. I'm not going to get into speculation such as like that. All I can say regarding our embassy, there were some stories that we are shutting it down. Not correct. I think that's speculation. We, of course, are monitoring the situation very carefully, but there are no plans as such of the nature that you mentioned. There was an issue of talks with Taliban. What is our reaction? Look, I just responded to that. We are in touch with various stakeholders involved in this, including regional countries. I have nothing further to add to that for the moment. Heart of Asia conference, External Affairs Minister had been there recently. I don't have an update on that process for the moment, but in all our conversations, we have been saying a similar message to all partners about, and which I have reiterated today, of how we look at the need to have a stable, prosperous, and democratic Afghanistan and a peace process that works towards that. I also got a query, I think, about allowing or helping people who want to come back from Afghanistan, female lawmakers or something. Look, I don't want to make a general comments, hypothetical situations. Let me reiterate what we are saying, that we have facilitated return of a large number of members of the Hindu and Sikh community last year. Our mission continues to be in touch with them, and we will ensure the provision of all necessary assistance to them. I don't want to say anything further. And about China, look, nothing specific on that. I don't have a specific comment on that. We are, as I said, in touch with all partners. And I'll leave it at that. Thank you. Yes, please. Not on Afghanistan, I presume. Okay. Moving on. Sorry? I did. I took your question about talks with Taliban, right? That's what it was. I said what I have to say on that. I'm sorry, I have nothing, no other additional comment on that. Regarding our talks with Taliban, right? Yeah. That was your question. Yeah, look, what they seek is their comment. No, I'm telling you our perspective on it. Okay, please. Yeah, go ahead.
Hi, sir. I'm from
ANI.
So, is there any advisory for the country against Rast who operates from other countries to India and using Afghanistan air route? So, there are conflicts between Taliban and Afghanistan is going on. So, is there a specific advisory for the airlines?
Sorry, didn't get your question. Are you talking about advisory to commercial aircraft while transiting Afghan airspace?
Yes.
Why should we issue that? Oh, you mean for Indian aircraft?
Yeah, obviously. Air India.
Fair enough. But that's back to Afghanistan. Anyway, is there anything else left in Afghanistan we haven't answered? Okay. Because, yeah, sorry, ma'am, your hand, yeah. Look, let me just finish with this question. Look, I am not aware of any such advisory on commercial aircraft transiting Afghanistan. I hope it doesn't come to that. Anyway, those who are transiting, you said, right? Transiting airspace, which not, or landing. Right now, I'm not aware of any such advisory, nor am I. I don't think anything immediate we are planning. But again, we are looking at the security situation very closely. We monitor it on a regular basis. On the leaders, some of there's a, yes, we have seen reports. In fact, yesterday, I think that the Americans announced some leader summit about democracy. I'll get back to you on that. It's still very recent, and I we'll check and we'll come back to you if there is any further on that. Sorry, next. Yes, please.
Shailesh from National Defense. My question is on China. What is the latest update on LAC vis-a-vis China? Is there any timeline drawn for disengagement or de-escalation?
Anybody else on China before we, okay. Look, on that, you would have seen the detailed press releases that we issued both after the commander level talks that happened, as well as the subsequent press release by the Ministry of Defense on the disengagement in the Gogra area. The disengagement process, that area of Gogra is now complete. And both sides are now in their respective permanent bases, as was mentioned in the press release of the Ministry of Defense. The landform has also been restored by both sides to the pre-standoff period. Both sides have also expressed commitment to take the talks forward and resolve the remaining issues along the LAC in the Western sector. Let me just end by saying, as you know, we have always maintained that disengagement followed by de-escalation would help our overall relations move forward. I don't have any particular update on timeline or other issues for the moment. Yes, please. आपने नीरव मोदी कहा ना जी जी देखिए ये जो वहाँ पे लीगल प्रोसीडिंग्स चल रहे हैं हम उसको क्लोज मॉनिटरिंग उसका हम हर रोज देखते रहते हैं क्या है हर हफ्ते का इसी हफ्ते ये हाई कोर्ट का एक जजमेंट जिसके आप जिक्र कर रहे थे पर मैं ये देख कहना चाहूँगा आपने भी देखा होगा आपने दो मुद्दों या दो बिंदुओं पर बात की है आप ये भी देखेंगे कि हाई कोर्ट ने बाकी तीन बिंदु को रिजेक्ट कर दिया है जो बड़े इंपॉर्टेंट बिंदु थे जिसमें अहमियत रखते हैं जिनको आर्गूमेंट उन्होंने कहा था कि हम क्यों एक्सट्रेडिशन नहीं हो सकता है और किस विषय से ये केस प्राइमा फेसी केस है और एक्सट्रेडिशन हो सकता है और अपील अलाउ कर दी गई है पर सिर्फ ये दो लिमिटेड ग्राउंड्स पे जो दो बिंदुओं की आपने बात की हम अपने तरफ से पूरी जो लीगल प्रोसीडिंग्स हैं उस पर हम जारी रखेंगे और हम कोशिश तो ये जारी उनके साथ नहीं आपने कहा बाकी जो बाकी सारे इकोनॉमिक फ्यूजिटिव्स हैं उन सबका यही हमारी तो यही प्रयास रहेगी कि वो वापस इंडिया आए और यहाँ पे हमारे जस्टिस सिस्टम को फेस करें आप और ऑप्शंस की बात कर रहे थे मैं उस पर जाना नहीं चाहूँगा कोई और ऑप्शन नहीं होता है इसमें लीगल ऑप्शंस होते हैं जुडिशियल ऑप्शन होते हैं और इस पर हम कोशिश हमारी जारी रहेगी आई सॉ हैंड देयर दैट्स अ सेकंड क्वेश्चन इफ आई हैव टू कम टू सेकंड क्वेश्चन आई थिंक विल एनीबॉडी एल्स दैट्स अ सेकंड क्वेश्चन नोबडी एल्स Okay, if that's the last two questions on a special, the first time, you have a second question too. No, this is getting too much. Okay, first question there. Okay, yeah, please. We'll take anybody who hasn't asked a question yet, please. And then since this is the first time we are doing this as a special bonus, mm-hmm. We'll take a 1 or 2 second question, but I think we are a little short on time. Yeah, please, ma'am. Look, I don't have that figure readily available, but my understanding is a lot of material came from China, but commercial. This was mostly procurements that happened. I am not sure if there was any aid or that's what you meant, no kind of aid, you said, assistance and aid. We had procured in our companies as well as from directly from the states of government had procured a lot of material during the second wave of the pandemic. And I think, and as you know, China is a place where a lot of people source their material from. But I'm not aware of any aid that had come in from China. Okay, is there no other person who wants to ask separately? Okay, then I'll take a quick 2-3 second questions.
My question is very important.
Oh, that will I vote on this? But anyway, please go ahead.
Sir, I'm a Gilles Suman from Samsung.
Yes.
Many students have applied in Canada and they are not being given visa. Visa process is very slow. So they have spent lots of money, their future is shaped. So what ABA is doing, any conversation with the Canadian authorities for processing the visa?
Anybody has a question related to that issue? Because this was an issue that had come up. Okay, let me try to understand. Let me not respond specifically vis-a-vis Canada, because there are many countries. There are many countries where, because of COVID, restrictions are there. And our, not just students, but other people who would like to travel are, facing some difficulties. As I have said earlier in the virtual, our media interactions, we attach high importance to ensuring, ease of these restrictions and of travel, whether they are live abroad for education or for employment or other reasons. We have been actively taking up this matter at various levels, in fact, including at the ministerial level, with almost all the countries that you can has been in the media. I'm happy to see some forward movement with some of the countries. And as our COVID situation in our country improves, we would hope that they will continue to take further measures to simplify and make it easier for particularly students and other people also to travel from India. So without going into specifics, let me just say, as you've been monitoring, there have been changes over the last few weeks and we see some positive developments, but I understand the difficulties many Indians still face in undertaking the travel, and EMEA will continue to attach high priority to this this issue, and I can assure you that our senior leadership and officials to raise this issue with our counterparts whenever and at every opportunity. Thank you. Sorry, you had they're all done with the first question. I thought we were doing a couple of second questions. No, this is, I think we're pretty close to it. Anybody really has a question to ask? Without which the... Okay. Vaccination ko leke puchi. Okay. Haan, batai. Kal clarification pehle.
Mujhe ye malum nahi hai kya Delhi London, London Delhi ka fare achanak kuch bada diye. Whether it is correct or wrong, I don't know exactly. So it specifically, you can answer it or it will be the...
Look, I don't think government can answer any case whether fares go up on by airlines unless it's Air India has increased it. I would hope that people do not try to take advantage of this situation. But beyond that, I don't think I should be. I would like to say anything. Sorry, vaccination. And we'll finish with you, the last one. देखिए, इसमें आपने दो तरह के क्वेश्चन है. इसमें ये कोवैक्सीन के बारे में अभी हमारे विदेश मंत्री डॉक्टर जयशंकर अभी CII से बात कर रहे थे हाल ही में, आधे घंटा पहले. उन्होंने जो कहा मैं उसी को दोहरा सकता हूँ. एक WHO का टाइम लगता है 6-8 हफ्ते करीब. हमारे ये अनुमान में July 9th को कोवैक्सीन भारत बायोटेक ने एप्लीकेशन कंप्लीट करके सबमिट किया था, सारे डॉक्यूमेंटेशन जो लगता है. तो हमारा अनुमान यही है या हम अपेक्षा ये रखते हैं कि अगस्त के एंड में या सितंबर के बिगिनिंग में कोई डिसीजन आए उनकी तरफ से, तो एक बार WHO से अप्रूवल आ जाए, इमरजेंसी यूज लिस्टिंग आ जाए, तो उससे काफ़ी हेल्प मिलेगा, क्योंकि ऑल्दो कोवैक्सीन काफ़ी देशों में ऑलरेडी है, पर WHO के जो ये सब अप्रूवल से उसमें आई थिंक उसका और हेल्प मिल सकता है बाकी कंट्रीज में। इम्पोर्ट के मामले में देखिए, हम तो कोशिश जारी रहे हमारी ताकि यहाँ पे अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ वैक्सीन बढ़ रहा है, डोमेस्टिक प्रोडक्शन हो या इम्पोर्ट का, पर इम्पोर्ट के एग्जैक्ट डिटेल्स हम नहीं डील करते हैं, वो आपको हमारे रेगुलेटरी अथॉरिटीज़ जो हैं वो बता पाएंगे बेटर। आपने कहा कि वैक्सीन कोवैक्सीन को बाकी कंट्री में अलाउ करते हैं नहीं करते हैं, ये मुद्दा भी अभी हमारे विदेश मंत्री जी ने अभी आंसर किया था, उसमें अभी आज ही मैं, आपने देखा नहीं होगा जब मैं आ रहा था। देखिए इसमें काफ़ी कंट्रीज़ में अपने अपने रूल्स हैं जो एक्सेप्ट हुए हैं, ये वैक्सीन मतलब नॉर्मली अप्रूवल वैक्सीन की दी जाती है जहाँ पे उस देश में यूज़ होती है वो वैक्सीन, पर हमें ऐसा देखना पड़ेगा कोई सोल्यूशन जिसमें ज़रूरी नहीं कि हर जगह आप अप्रूवल लें और वैक्सीन मान जाए, तो इसीलिए हम काफ़ी देशों से बात में हैं कि हमारे वैक्सीनेशन सर्टिफिकेट्स मान जाए हमारे जो यहाँ वैक्सीन है, उस तरह से उन देशों के वैक्सीन को भी हो सकता है बाकी किसी तीसरे देश में ही माने, पर अभी तक उसमें ज़्यादा मूवमेंट हुआ नहीं है, पर कुछ कंट्रीज मान चुके हैं, तो हम इसी कोशिश में हम जारी रहेंगे। Siddhant, I promise you last one, so I'll close it with that.
The White House has announced that there will be a summit, advocacy summit.
I answered that one.
So
I just answered her on that,
okay.
Which is to say that we have seen that yesterday. It's just recent, and we'll get back to you if you have any update on it. For the moment, we'll check the details. It just happened yesterday, and we don't have any further on that yet. Thank you. Yeah, tell me. Yes. Look, as you know, the United States had announced its intention of hosting an in-person Quad summit. I don't have a date or anything yet. Once we have an update, we'll share with you. But yes, that's something that I think had been announced, and I think the US is trying to work out some kind of a date, perhaps. Then mentioned end of the year. Thank you very much. I think that's been a little longer than usual, and I know we had some technical issues. Really nice to see all of you in person here in this room with all the COVID restriction and protocols that we followed. Thank you very much for being here, and hope we continue this interaction every week.